Welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited today, you guys, because these watermarks are like the best thing I bought this year so far. So today I'm gonna talk about introjects. So what is an introject? An introject, as per Wikipedia, is the unconscious adoption of the thoughts or personality traits of others. It occurs as a normal part of development, such as a child taking on parental values and attitudes. It can also be a defense mechanism in situations that arouse anxiety. Introjects are passed to us since we are babies and we develop them in our family structure. So back to the fact of reproduction. If you want to have a kid to create a mini version of yourself, for example, that you can control or put ideas in their head, you might create just another adult narcissist with self-esteem issues. I know this was savage to start this episode with. I just want to be clear where I come from the beginning. However, if you have kids and teach them how to make them think, both of you will always learn from each other. We are born in nature and kids love experimenting with it. However, after going to school, their curiosity and creativity dies crushed. The mistake is because we make them memorize numbers and data to adapt to the established patterns of society. They get a convergent thinking instead of divergent. Does this sound crazy to you? You cannot get educated by this self-propagating system in which people study to pass exams and teach others to pass exams. But nobody knows anything. You learn something by doing it yourself, by asking questions, by thinking, and by experimenting. For example, you might have grown up in an environment where if you did something wrong or broke something or spilled the water or dropped your phone, your parents' reactions were always to get upset or show discomfort or to shout at you. This only makes a kid scared and they don't know how to cope. If, however, we get to their level, our knees, and ask them, what do we do about the water on the table? That's how they learn to be problem solvers. Honestly, it's not difficult, it's just there is not a parenting book. Well, nowadays there are, but you know what I mean. This is how to teach a kid something you learned by making a mistake, and this is a healthy way of being patient and asking them to think. This way also you create a connection rather than a disconnection. First of all, my first advice here is to surrender your ego and question everything you've always known. Challenge your beliefs and have conversations with people who disagree with you. Because getting upset when someone else has a different point of view or calling them weird only feeds your own ego to keep believing your reality is, and quote unquote, the right one. How about stop thinking about life as right or wrong? How about stop having discussions with your partner about who is right and instead try to compromise that maybe you are both right or both wrong? There is no point in being right about anything because that doesn't make anybody grow. Understanding that little voice inside you and not letting it rule your life is actually evolution. solution? What makes you have a long-term relationship is to listen to the other person, not to always try to be right and perfect in front of them. In fact, nobody's ever going to be 100% right or 100% at fault. Since I understood this, wow, my life changed and the relationship with my husband changed, because now I approach every conversation from a healthier place and I know I need to take responsibility for things I didn't pay attention to. I think in the beginning of my channel I mentioned how I think some people might get offended. This happens when someone resonates with what you're saying, and if this is happening to you, you might resonate with what I'm saying. But please understand, I'm not attacking you. If you think I am, this is how you play the victim role, and I'm not saying you particularly. I'm just trying to bring up a different type of issue and character. Without thinking what might be happening actually, it's important that we approach conversations, discussions and problems from one place and only one, understanding how the other one is feeling. Not judging, not shaming, not insulting, not blaming, not closing up, upset like this is a personal. Discussion is not about winning or losing. When there is an argument, it's very easy to feel offended and play the victim role. I think we can all relate to this. If someone resonates with what you're saying, it might be because their ego knows they acted wrong. Saying this is just the way I am is also not valid anymore. So, how do we get better at this then? I highly recommend you read and investigate the 9 Enneagrams. I've heard people say they prefer to read the horoscope. The zodiac points towards predetermination based on your birth date, time, and place, while the Enneagram points to self-determination based on a personal and accurate assessment of your habit of attention. Only you can identify your Enneagram type and your wounds. So what is the Enneagram then? Wow, today I'm unveiling a lot of information. The Enneagram is a model of the human psyche, which is principally understood and taught as a typology of 9 interconnected personality types, as per Wikipedia. Or like Borja Villaseca explains, in these 9 mental models, psychological skeletons or personality types, each of which can be lived from the ego or from the being, depending on our level of consciousness, our degree of understanding, and our state of mind. I encourage you to find yours so you can start acting from an honest place. Because understanding who you are and why you respond one way or another to different situations is critical in any upbringing. Of course it isn't easy, nothing about self-learning is easy. No one wants to confront their worst self or why they act as a victim. Because when you get upset and leave the room, there is no justification other than being disrespectful to who you live in the room. And again, you are just playing the victim role. Confront your ego. You and be vulnerable to show empathy instead. Stay in the room That's why it's so important to work through and deal with uncomfortable situations. Anyways, I'll leave you here for now.